right time.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We have a time in the word of the Lord on today. Amen. Amen. Someone say meditation.
Meditation.
Before manifestation.
Before manifestation.
Meditation before manifestation. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The Bible says that we walk by faith and not by sight. That's not a mystery rhyme, but that's prophetic. If you don't get the revelation of that, you're going to be left on the outside of the kingdom. Amen?
Amen.
And so it's very important to embrace and in-house everything that God says.
Amen.
Amen? Now the Bible said that faith cometh by hearing. Then it said that hearing by the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Did we hear that? And let me say that again. Faith cometh by hearing. And hearing by the word of the Lord.
Amen.
So notice the word is last. But the word say the last shall be first. So what God is saying in the message is the word must have preeminence.
Yes.
Because faith can only come where the word is. Are we getting this?
Yeah.
I'm gonna teach you today.
Amen.
Okay. I'm gonna let you know you got what it takes, and if you don't have what it takes, you have by the end of this session, you can take it with you. Amen? Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word. Now someone say, God bless my hearing.
God bless my hearing.
You need to hear from God like you breathe air every day.
Amen.
Are you following what I'm saying? We need to hear from God every day. And someone say, hearing for details.
Hearing for details.
I'm going to need some details.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Hebrews 11:1 say, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Someone say, of things hoped for.
Of things hoped for.
What goes on with your faith is your hope.
Amen.
You don't go to a steakhouse unless you got the expectation and the hope of steak coming out.
Come on now.
You don't go to the steakhouse wanting chicken.
See.
You're in the wrong house. You follow what I'm saying? You have to position yourself in the place of hope to receive the faith. Are we understanding that? See, the word of God is a transformer, and God is also an equalizer. You hear it, didn't I say?
Amen.
Because why he says an equalizer? Because he makes everything even with himself. Only time there is a struggle with anything is because we moved from the rhythm in the place of hearing the word of God.
Amen.
Think about it. You hear words every day. You in a culture that taught word. So give the kingdom of God functions off a word. It don't function because you have a need.
Amen.
The kingdom of God don't function, Sister Kimmy, because you in trouble. The kingdom of God functions off of the word. There is a lingo. There is a language. Your 911 won't move God. The whole world got needs. So your need don't move God. Is God still loving? Yes, he is. I'm going somewhere with this. I'm not lost, trust me. I've meditated the word of God. We're going to get into some things. You stick around longer, this word works. I tell you, the word works.
Yes, it does.
I put the word, but when your money fails, the word doesn't. You don't have to go down with the economy because you're not of this economy. Do you understand? This is a Babylonian system that inflation and all kinds of stuff, recession, all kinds of stuff. Prices go up, prices go down.
sake.
And your money go with it. You follow what I'm saying? But God said you are this world. You in this world, but you're not of this world. When I went to Germany years ago, and I was over there 21 days, Sister Margot, I was in Germany, but I wasn't a German.
See.
And so therefore, my resources didn't come from there. I was covered. My economical system wasn't based on them. Because my currency wasn't of them.
Come on now.
Are you following what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. See, so you're you're an ambassador. Someone said ambassador.
Ambassador.
You're an ambassador that is in a culture that you in it, but you're not of it. Ambassador is taken care of from the country he come from, no matter what's happening in the place that he is. And so that has to become revelation. Now, that's nothing that you can just quote. I'm going to show you something in a minute. Go over to Matthew, the 13th chapter. So I'm going to say the word works.
The word works.
If it ever gets off in you, the word works.
Yes, it does.
I said if the word of God ever gets off in you, the word of God works. And the word of God don't discriminate. It doesn't care what part of life you're in. Because everything moving and breathing came up out of God. Believe it or not. Believe it or not, I don't care who you like, who you dislike, who did what. Nothing exists without the breath of God.
Amen.
From human beings to insects that you can't even see. From the smallest little thing in the ocean, God made it. Are you following what I'm saying? Yes. And God knows what he was making when he was making it. And he designed everything to function after his kind. Are you following?
Amen.
See, it's more to you than you think. I said it's more to you than you think. That's why the enemy put so much warfare around you, because he don't want you to tap into your God self. Notice I said God, I didn't say yourself, I said your God self.
Come on now.
And what's frustrating is because we're trying to live as a human being and instead of living as Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Come on now.
Are you following what I'm saying? The Bible said creation is groaning and travailing for the manifestation of the sons of God. Which, when you say the word son, you're not dealing with gender. You did it with the essence of relationship. The spirit, essence of a thing, is the spirit of a thing. It's the spirit. It's no gender. I'm going somewhere with this here. So creation is groaning for you to be like God in the earth. Because creation is wanting you to deliver it.
Hello.
You ain't heard it. You got to bring salvation to creation.
Come on,
you
man.
Ain't heard nothing I say. Now that God has brought salvation to you, you got to bring salvation to creation. That's why you got to have enough word in you to prophesy and call those things that be not as though they were. How many understand that God gave you the world to inherit? That sound kind of sad. You know, people get revelations on you right there. But God, he didn't just put you in the world because he was born. He put you in the world to inherit it. Can we talk about it? I'm going to Matthew 13, but allow me to state my case. The lawyer always made his case. Then he tries to win the people after he states his case and make the case. Let me make the case. Adam and Eve was put in the Garden of Eden. Why? Adam wasn't put in the garden to disappear and go into failure. But however, it didn't surprise God. But Adam and Eve was put in the garden to inherit it.
Amen.
That's the first Adam. He said, be fruitful and multiply. He said, Adam, whatever you call a thing, it would be. Whatever you name it, it will be. You can make it great. You can make it small. Some would say it's your calling this season.
It's your calling, y'all.
You can make the enemy bigger than you. You can make him small. You can make it not even exist. You don't have to be reveling. See, every situation don't have to be reveling in your life. How many is here? Are you hearing me, Brother Justin? You see what I'm saying? See, believe it or not, he made you a shot caller.
Hello.
I said, you're a shot caller. How many is hearing this?
Amen.
You're a shot caller. You're not waiting for someone to see, you're waiting for somebody. No, you're a shot caller.
Come on now.
Creation is waiting for you to prophesy.
Hello.
Creation is waiting on you to say something. Creation is waiting on that kingdom conversation.
Amen.
Are we hearing this? I need you to keep your stay right there. I need you to follow me, sir. Are we hearing this here? The most excellent thing you can do is out of the Word of God. Now, anytime God, watch this here, when God trusts you with himself, and which is his word, everything else is an add-on. You hear that? I see. What if God, the creator, then gave you himself, what can you not possess? Think about it. Are you hearing? What's the problem? Now, if God, the creator, then gave you Christ in you, the hope of glory. The creator say, he think enough of you to say, let me get in you and embody you. Let me come a part of your life.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Christ in you, the whole greatest, he is in you, he is in the word. Let me live in you. I want you to house me. I'm spirit, you spirit, but I need a body or else I'm illegal. So I want to get off in you and function in the earth.
Amen.
I want to function in you. I know you want a house, but can you house me?
Hello.
If you house me, what you trying to reach is secondary.
Hello.
Because I made everything. You need to be in good standing with me.
Yes.
See, while you reach, I need you just contact me because I know everybody. Oh, Bob, you trying to get home too? I know it. I know all about Bob. I know his wife. I made him. He came up out of me. You have a problem with coming to me? Deal with Bob. Deal with me. I made Bob. Let me tell you how to get next to Bob. You hear nothing. See, the strategy of the prophetic. You hear nothing. I said the strategy of the prophetic. God is a strategizer. He's an equalizer. You hear nothing. I said, can I work it like a fiddle? See, he'll make the plane, the grounds even, because he's an equalizer. And he's a transformer. While yet equalizing, transformer. You ain't hear nothing. I said, you don't want to work, but can I teach it like a fiddle? Can I bring you from one dispensation to the other dispensation? I know I told you Matthew 13. We'll try to get there, but listen. Enjoy the journey while you're trying to make the destination.
Yeah.
Okay. So you need to understand that God created the world for you to inherit.
Come on now.
So when Adam, the first Adam, missed it. Come on here. Through a conversation. He missed it because he didn't hear right. When his hearing got messed up. So when your hearing get messed up, your decision gonna get messed up. And when your decision get messed up, your reality gonna get messed up. And when your reality is messed up, your life is messed up.
Come on now.
You hear nothing I see. Can I teach you like a fiddle? I'm gonna bring it to you. I don't care what age you, I'm gonna drop it off wherever you at. You'll be able to chew this. You won't have no excuse. Give you something to drink. Are y'all here with me?
Amen.
That's why when things went crazy and they took of another language, they bit of another truth.
Come on now.
Wasn't the apple, it was a truth. That they bit of a message. Another message. They bit of something from another kingdom. And that's why they lend their ear to a curse.
Hello.
Come on.
See, that's why you gotta take heed what you hear. They was on track, Sister Kimberly, but they loaned their ear out to otherness.
See,
they loaned their ear out to that God wasn't saying.
Yes.
And the power in the midst of the promise, how in the midst of everything, you in a created a situation. You in a situation where It's going to be according to your imagination. See, the greatest nation is your imagination. Not the United States, but your imagination.
Come on here.
You can like my body, but you can't like my mind.
Come on here.
Ask Mandela. If he was living, he would tell you. They locked me out for 27 years, but they made the mistake. They didn't like my mind.
Wow.
And so what? In 27 years, I was in the process of metamorphosing my mind to become the president of the country that had enslaved me.
Come on.
You ain't hearing what I'm saying. I thought this ain't Bible. This is in your generation.
Amen.
But see, you locked the body, but you didn't lock the mind.
Come on,
and if a man don't put your mind on lockdown, you still free.
Amen.
You can lock my body, but I'll send my mind, because I can sit right here and go all over the world. I can sit right here. Now, when I get locked up, I just left out of Germany just that quick. I went to Carson Bender just that quick. Look, I didn't need my body.
Hello. Come on now.
To hear in the spirit or think in the spirit.
Come on now.
Two different entities. See, when you begin to step into the mind of God, you step into the eternity of the assignment. Mm. For there is no limit when you step into the eternity of the assignment. Uh-huh. You hear nothing I say. Nothing can stop you, Brother Sam, when you step into the eternity of the assignment, because your assignment was designed to outlast your body.
Wow.
Okay. Are you hearing nothing?
Wow.
Still is this. Still, once it's happening, it's still got to be talked about. Come on, Peter, they gone, but you're still talking about it. Come on, Paul, you're gone, but you're still talking about that experience.
Come see on, now.
The experience never leaves. The residue never leaves. Come on, the victory never leaves.
Jesus.
You know, we don't need nothing. Everything's on fire. See, everything about your life is on fire. Linda, help us. And so you ain't got to be credentialed every time you go before God, because you go after God. 1 John 4:17. As he is, so are we in the earth. As he is, you got to begin to function from the dispensation of as he is. You got to approach that dilemma as he is.
Come on.
You ain't hear nothing I say. What you mean? As he is. God, you know what? As he is, so are you in the earth. So are you in the now. You turn away for God. You pray on the other side. But God said, He told us, pray that thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Come on, yeah.
You turn to go to heaven, and God trying to get heaven to you. Heaven said, hey, buddy, where you going? Come here, Tim. Just walk by. Hey, buddy, where you going? Heaven's coming out. I'm heaven. You earth. So where you going? You ain't got to try to come to me. I'm coming to you. Let's come. Let's walk with me. Let's walk with the
Lord.
Speak. Say this. Holy Spirit, tell you what to say. Say this. Holy Spirit's always talking through you, as you, for you. Talking through you, as you, for you. You're not alone. When you think you ain't got no way, Holy Spirit says something else. Say, you got it. I got it. Tell me you want it. You get the number. Don't get the number. Listen to me. The number says to me, I said you can have it. I want it. You don't see no provision. But the provision is, I want it.
Come on, man.
Wow.
The word becomes a currency.
Come
here. Oh.
I said the word becomes a currency. Yeah. So the guy says your dancing studio is going to be $2 million. You look in the bank, it ain't there. Holy Spirit say, sign the papers.
Hello.
You hear nothing I said?
Yeah.
You don't see it from this dispensation.
Right.
But the word has spoken it.
Yes.
And so now you don't see it. Now watch this here. You don't see it. You just put away your wallet. And here comes a ram in the bush. Got on white jeans and a shirt. And said, I was at my office and the Lord told me to buy your studio. You ain't hear nothing I said?
Yeah.
Hey, you ain't hear nothing I said? I seen a black jacket and some jeans that look like mine.
See,
you hear nothing I said?
Yes.
You see what I'm talking about? You see? Yes. See, you done limit yourself by this.
Come out here.
I got 81 credit. I got every card in here. Baby, let me tell you something. I want you to hear this word. If you listen to me, if media land, if you listen to me in this room, as a prophet, there's some things you're about to believe for that you won't have to pay for. You better take that to the bank, son. You better take that one to the bank. That's the things you're going to enter that you're not going to pay for because you believe it's going to show up.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Are you following me, sir?
Amen.
It won't be about your heart, lady. You're going to sleep in houses that you never built. You're going to possess homes that the credit said no, but God said yes.
Yes.
You ain't heard nothing I said. When God shows up, he eagles the playing field. He comes against the odds. He's an eagle. When the odds are stacked against you, he comes and makes the ground plain. He's an eagle.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
You hear nothing I see?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Young man out of Cleveland, Ohio. How'd you get to be dancing with all them people over there? Yeah, you practice. I'm watching you yesterday. Look at the temple. It's showing out. It's showing out. Sticking out like a big phone. It's showing out. I mean, me and Sam was talking. I said, look at him. It's beside himself. It's catching on quickly.
Amen. Hallelujah.
See, you ain't got to be in the crowd to be in the crowd. You ain't got to be on the stage, on the big stage, to be on the big stage.
Same.
Got to come right in that corner and say, I need you for the big stage.
Same.
You hear nothing else. You wouldn't bother nobody.
Oh,
I wouldn't either. I just got a phone call. There's a young man at your church that dances from another dispensation. Say. His feet says something. His feet prophesies.
Come on, man.
Say. You hear nothing I say. Oh. His arms is a message.
Yeah.
His mood is a message.
Favor
don't play fair.
Come on, Gil.
Come on, man.
When you listen. When you're hearing, when you're getting kingdom doubt to take care of a temporary issue.
Say,
amen.
Kingdom doubt. Are y'all hearing this?
Yes.
Now listen to this here. I'm going to show you something. Listen to this here. I'm going to show you how this thing functions. I'm going to show you how you can use it. It'll work in your daily life. It'll change anybody's decision. Matthew 13:10, the disciples came and said to him, why do you speak to them in parable? And he said, he answered them, it is given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. For to him who has, will more be given. What is he talking about? To him that has word, more word be given. To him that has the revelation, more revelation will be given. See, first of all, can God trust you with his word?
Yes, sir.
But he will trust you with his creation, he can trust you with his word. See, if you can't handle me, you can't handle my creation. You want me to give you my stuff, but I gotta know, do you respect me?
Hello.
You trying to walk all over my house. Wait a minute, let's stop. Do I have a relationship with you? Yeah, I know I said that in my father's house, there's many mansions, places of provision, but I can't let you pass the door from where you first believe until I know your faith over that you first believe, which is me. Christ in you, the hope of glory. Are you hearing me, sister Jeff?
Yes.
See, and how you treat me determines whether I give you the key to my house or not.
Come on, can you trust me?
Mm-hmm. Can you be king? That's good. Can you be kingdom trusted?
Yes, sir.
Are you kingdom worthy?
Come on.
Yeah. Are y'all here? Are you hearing me, sir?
Yes, sir.
Can I trust you with the big stake? But let me see how you handle the small stake.
See?
Let me see how your spirit act as the door is open. Let me see if you're going to stay. Come on. Let me see how you're going to treat your leader. Let me see how you're going to treat your prophet. I'm going to see if you're going to denounce him. Someone says, God bless you, don't get bigger than your blessing. Now listen. For to him who has, will more be given. And he which have, and will have abundance. But from him who has not, even that he has will be taken away.
Hmm.
See, the little you know of him, he said, I removed that. You ain't doing nothing with it. Therefore, I speak to them in parable, because they look, but do not see.
Hmm.
If you're going to look, you might as well see.
See.
He said, they look, but they don't see. You'd be surprised of people that's sitting up around the word today, but they ain't seen. They look at it, but they ain't seen. They see a white shirt, a pair of jeans, and they missed the revelation.
See.
And that ain't what God is advertising.
See, okay.
See, you focus on the wrong thing. They look at some locks coming down your back, and they can't get with it. But you got everything dressed up and closed up in a row. What is that?
Hello.
What does it sound like? Faith comes by hearing.
Yes, sir.
Not by the way something look.
Say,
even that that's teaching you.
Say.
You hear nothing I say?
Oh, you better get this.
You may not have no suit and tie.
Say.
Are you following what I'm saying? You don't know how your blessing's gonna come.
Come on, man, about hearing the Lord's life.
You better learn that. You better know that voice.
Yes, no.
Huh? Come on, you better know that voice. Now listen to this here. He says it, because they look but do not see. And they listen but they do not hear. They listen but they do not hear. See. Neither do they understand. In them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah saying, which says, by hearing you will not hear, and shall not understand. And seeing you will see, and shall not perceive. For this people's heart or spirit has grown dull. You know, you can disobey God so long, your spirit get dull.
Hello.
You get so set in your ways, your spirit get dull. Because I'm going to tell you something, if you ain't hearing faith, your spirit going to get dull.
Amen.
Their ears have become hard of hearing, and they have closed their eyes. Can't hear in the spirit, can't see in the spirit, man. That's why I'm careful, Sister Joan, who prophesied to me.
Amen.
I got to know, are you skillful?
Say.
Are you a skillful seer? Are you a skillful hearer?
Come on,
man. It's a difference in quoting scripture and quoting revelation.
Hello.
See, when you meditate on it, you're going to be quoting revelation, not just scripture.
See.
Because you got to act as you quote scripture. And ain't even saved. Now listen to this here. Verse 15. For this people's heart has grown dull, their ears have become hard of hearing, and they have closed their eyes, lest they should see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and turn and should heal, and heal people. But blessed are your eyes. Listen here. He said, blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. For truly I say to you that many prophets and righteous men have desired to see those things which you see, tell me this day, and have not seen them, and to hear those things which you hear, and have not heard them. Did you know that prophets of old longed to hear what you're hearing today, but didn't see it?
Come on,
and couldn't hear it? And we've been given revelation by the Holy Ghost, because see, back in the days of old, in the Old Testament, they weren't filled with the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God came upon them. Now the Spirit of God lives in you. The Spirit of God visit them, but now you house him.
Hello.
Are you following what I'm saying? See, they had visitation and we got habitation.
Come on.
Are you following what I'm saying? You got it 24/7. You ain't got to pray, man. You just got to use it.
Hello.
You ain't got to speak in tongues to get it. He's already there.
Hello.
You got to acknowledge the presence of the God. Are we hearing this here?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now listen to it. Verse 18 says, therefore listen to the parable of the sower. Then when anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away that which was sown in his spirit. Mm-hmm. See, when there's no understanding, that no revelation of it, that even though you quoted it, the enemy can take it before you get to God.
Yep.
And so you jumped and shouted in the presence of God, but when you left there, because the presence wasn't in you, the word was gone.
Say,
now you're in defeat.
Jesus.
Are we hearing this here?
Yes,
this is the one who receives seed beside the path. But he who receives a seed on rocky ground is he who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet he has no root in himself. But yet he receives it with joy. He's excited about it. He makes note about it. But then He has, it's not rooted in his spirit. The word of God is not rooted in his spirit. See, that it ain't in his subconscious. It was on the pad, but it never got in his spirit. He heard it, but it wasn't dropped in his spirit.
It takes an intimacy.
Now I'm gonna show you something. Show you about fellowship.
Right.
Now listen to this here. But he who, 25, but 20, Matthew 13, 20. But he who receives the seed on rocky ground is he who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet he has no root in him, but endures for a while. Endures for a moment. You ever seen that? You ever been like that yourself?
Come on.
You ever seen somebody like endure for a moment? Mm-hmm. Then they start talking down. Mm-hmm. They just came out of prayer and full of hell.
Hello.
Came out of prayer and negative.
Come on.
Prayer came out of prayer and ain't talking the kingdom, talking all them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Run from people that, look here, let me tell you something. When I hear faith, I ain't got time for your negativity.
Amen.
You gotta be disciplined.
Come on now. Verse, for when the tribulation or persecution arise because of the word, you say tribulation rise because of the word. Because of the word. See, it's the word being dry.
See.
It's your faith on dry.
Hello.
I said, when the word comes, it's gonna put your faith on dry.
Right.
Someone say faith on dry. It ain't about the devil, it's your faith on dry. Your faith is on trial in this situation. It ain't about the job you don't have. It ain't about the car you don't have. It ain't about the money. Your faith on trial. The language of the kingdom is on trial. But you better get a revelation and never lost the case.
Come on.
You can peep over to the back of the book. We win.
Come on,
I remember when I was a little boy in the first grade and I was having trouble in math, and one day I was studying, I don't know what to do now. I was looking and I was trying to figure out some things and I couldn't get it. And something just told me to go to the back of the book. And so when I went to the back of the book, every answer to every chapter was in the back of the book. And so immediately I went back to the front and began to go through the process. And I learned. Watch this here. I learned the front of the book from the back of the book.
Amen.
I didn't have to cheat because I knew those answers was there for me. I had to read the story and put it together, and I learned the why it was there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So when you're going through hell in your life, go to the back of the book. Read Revelation and say we win. It literally said we win. Read the back of the book. Going out and say we win. Before it closed the book, it said you win. So if you don't understand the secret, that last chapter, they tell you, man, you go look at their bills. Man, you gotta go to that last chapter of Revelation when they talk about what they gonna do. Wait a minute. Let me get them jokers a call. Do you understand our win? Get that house ready for me. Are you following what I'm saying, y'all? Nobody can count you out when you'd have been counted in.
Hello.
You ain't heard nothing I say.
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, man of God.
You ain't heard nothing I say.
Yeah.
See, God will take your life and play chess with it.
Come on.
One day he have your pawn, he have your king, spade. It depends on what moves you want to make. It's what he make you become in there.
Say.
If you want to run the board, y'all ain't heard nothing I say. What did I stop at? Matthew 3rd, I stopped at.
Was I 20?
Why am I on this page? Do y'all know where I stopped at? Y'all just want to hear that. That's something y'all want to hear. We stopped at 21:20, but well, I tell you, people just take over your sermon. Yeah, of course they start saying, "Yeah, right." Get out 20 years, 21 here, 20. 21. I'm there, 21. That's good. Let's get back to the word. We on 20, okay?
Yeah,
it's 21. It's whatever the wife, but you still live as we are. So I know how to get along. That's why I've been married 30 years.
Amen.
Yield. That's how you ride, brother. Ride. That's how you you stay married 30 years, you yield. You may be the head, but she the neck, and she'll turn you the way she wants. Give me a revelation, man. Hey. Say, honey, you don't run nothing. Say, you're right. That's why I'm shaving up my heels now. Don't run nothing. But he who received, verse 20, but he who received the seed on rocky ground is he who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet he has no root in himself. But endure it for a while. Some say a while won't do. For when tribulation, persecution arise because of the word, eventually he falls away. Can't handle it. He also who receives seed among the thorn is he who hears the word, but he carries of this world. He also who receives seed among the thorns is he who hears the word. But the cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word.
Peter 21, because he say because he is offended.
And he also receives seed among the thorns. He is, okay. Yet he has no root in himself, but endures for a while, for when tribulation or persecution arrives because of the word, eventually he falls away. That's offense.
We use the word offended.
See, offended people, you know what? One thing I know about people that's always offended, they're not forgiving people either. Anybody easy that get offended, them people ain't forgiven either. It's always something. You offend me. You're unforgiving too. You're offended. You can't be great being offended. You gotta have tough skin to be in leadership.
Amen.
You gotta have tough skin to be on the big stage. To be in truth, man, you gotta know how to be the backup singer, and you may sound better than the solo artist.
Come on now.
I remember one time I had a friend used to sing for, he was background singer for Diana Ross. And they came to you back in the days of Unarena, those that live around here. And Diana Ross made the mistake, you know, when the concert over, how they let each one say some drums through their thing, different speakers through their thing, and they made a mistake. And passed the mic. And boy, I tell you what, you should see them trying to get that mic back. Because House was on their feet for the backup singer.
Say,
the backup singer was backing up. I'm coming out, but when he came out, she was like, I want the world. Well, the world had just seen that backup singer.
Say,
and I need you to give me that mic and you get back, because you're about to steal my shot. So.
But remember another scripture says, be not offended in me, which is the truth, saying, stop being offended by the truth.
Right.
Don't let the truth offend you.
Right, because it take care of itself. 22 says, he also receives seed among the thorns, and is he who hears the word, but the cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becomes unfruitful. But he who receives the seed on good ground is he who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit. Some produce 160, 30 times that was sown. Now that growth level depends on how you meditate. Now with that being said, let me go over to Joshua right quick. I'm gonna show you something. Stay with me in the spirit. Y'all with me? Y'all okay? Y'all there? See, I'm gonna show you something. See, this word comes through fellowship. To spend time with God.
Yes.
Every ministry, you're going somewhere with this. Are y'all all right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Y'all okay? Okay, just stay with me. Here we go, right here.
That here is more than Sunday.
Amen.
Joshua 1:8. If this reads different, then I'm going to read it. I like the King James version, though. But Joshua 1:8. Let me find it here. This is a new Bible. C7:8. Okay, it's an 8 says. And listen to it. It says, this book of the law must not depart from your mouth. But I want to read it from King James. Somebody give me King James. because there's a point I want to make. That's King James? Okay, it's King James, King James, yes, King James. Okay, it says, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night. No, it says, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate. What is he saying here? Let me see what he's saying here. He's simply saying here is this. He said, before you speak this word, I want you to meditate on it first. Don't even try to speak this till you meditate. Listen to what it's saying. See, we read that all together, but it's giving you a direction. God has given Joshua some direction. He said, this book, talking about law, the book, the word of God. This book of the law, the one you got, the one I'm teaching you. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night. But thou shalt meditate. This word has become your meditation day and night. I don't even want you to try to speak this word till you meditate. You got to get this word. How do you meditate the word? You get the word off in your subconscious and you keep rehearsing that word. I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. Christ in me, the hope of glory. Your subconscious is hearing that, and your subconscious will house what you say.
Hello.
That's why when you forget something, and you walk around the house, you say, man, where's that thing at? Where's that thing at? Then finally, your subconscious kick in. Until your subconscious, while you look at the subconscious, I already know what it is. It's waiting for you to calm down. Because your subconscious can't work under pressure. You hear nothing I say. You ever look for your keys, they right before you. You done accused the whole house of your keys. Your shoes and mad at everybody now. You lost them. And then you ever had some keys in your hand? One time I had some keys in my hand. And I was mad. I said, where is my keys? I had put the ring through my finger. And the keys were here in the ball of my hand. I went, where is my key? Who moved my keys? I'm going through the house and you feel so silly when the subconscious kick in. Because you didn't tear up the house and accuse everybody of your keys. Look, innocent kids and everything. Look, babies, everything, everybody. You're just bad. You see what I'm saying? See, y'all left because you done been there. Everybody lost up in your house and was getting upset. They told you once they didn't get it, so why did you get mad at them? They told you when you answered, I don't have it. Yeah, you do. Yeah, you said, yeah, you do. You done said, yeah, you do in your house. You done said. Uh-huh, see? But the subconscious kicked in and say, hey, silly, they in your head. And then the right thing to do is go back and tell everybody, I'm fine. Put your ease out the door. Because you feel sick.
Right.
And then you wait till you get off the ease and say, you know, I found those keys. Because you had to meditate on that thing a little more. Because you don't want nobody that you were silly.
Right.
See, y'all had it because y'all
didn't.
Y'all ready to say something? Let me finish this. So he says here, listen to this here. So I'm trying to get a picture with this word. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou may observe to do according to all that is written therein. Now watch this here. For then when? Then. Now notice it says meditation before manifestation.
Yeah.
Right? It said, remember I told you, meditation before. Are you seeing Mrs. Kimberly? It says meditation. Here it is right here. Here's the title of the message. Broke down. Meditation before manifestation. So here it is in scripture.
Right.
Because you gotta get scripture because people listen, he says something foreign I've never heard it in my life. That's what you're doing here. Don't blame it on me.
Hello.
You know why people think you're speaking heresy because they don't study the Bible? That was heresy. No, you say read that part of the scripture in Revelation.
No.
Now listen to this here. So he says here, now listen here. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein. Meditate. That ain't nothing for him. That's not a cult.
Right.
That's not a cult. Meditation, candles, Man, give you some candles and some water. Go by the ocean. Man, you want to hear from God? Man, get around some water.
Come on.
I told my wife the other day, I went out by the pool. And I hollered, and you know, I cracked the door there, and so I went out by the pool. I said, honey, guess where I am? She said, where you at? I'm in the Bahamas. I was outside by the pool. I said, me, the Lord's my imagination.
Say.
You hear nothing I say. Huh? See, I meditated. I was out there meditating, and so my mind had left the house. I said, honey, ask me what I'm doing. By the ocean. I don't know about a pool. But my seek your mind. Meditate. Mm-hmm. Are you following what I'm saying? See, if you carry your mind there, your body pretty soon come. You hear me? You hear me? I say, if you let your mind have the experience, your body will too. If you let your mind be at peace, your household will be at peace. You hear nothing I say? If you buy that thing in your mind, whatever it is you want, buy it with your mind. I said buy it with your mind. And I guarantee you're going to drive with it, you're going to live in it, you're going to wear it, or whatever. Because it's yours for the taking.
Amen.
Jesus.
Work, Holy
Spirit. Can I share something with y'all? You know God don't want y'all just be bowing down to him all the time like this. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. He don't have no self-esteem. What kind of God you got? God like doing stuff. The God I said like going places and doing stuff.
Come on, man.
Is it, you see that? You see that? The big one I made that. See, sometimes, you know why you're frustrated? Because sometimes you hang around smiling too long.
Say,
uh-oh.
You ain't heard nothing. It ain't even the devil mess with smile kicking your butt.
Ooh, yep. Jesus.
Get this shot.
Say.
If he can't handle that, he can't handle that load of money gonna knock his hand off. But if money comes, it'll be bitter. So you want to be rich? So you think you can be rich? So you think? Let me be sure. Do you want to be rich? And run principles.
All right.
For 10 points, tell me what the scripture is. For $1 million. This problem is crazy. Where do I stop? Anybody know where I stop at? Joshua 8. Oh, this book of the law shall. This book of the law. Okay, that's the wrong Bible. So you're going to take my glass off, you start picking up everything. You got to stay focused. Now, watch this here. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou may observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. Who gonna make your way prosperous? You are. How? Through meditation. Meditation, revelation, manifestation. Meditation, revelation, manifestation. Meditation, revelation, manifestation. Meditation, revelation, manifestation. Get this written. Do this here. Say meditation.
Meditation.
I need everybody's participation. Meditation. Do you end like this here?
Meditation.
Revelation.
Manifestation.
That's what the word's telling you right here? Huh? What's the word telling you right here?
What's the
word? For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. And then thou shalt have not just success, good success. You ain't heard nothing. I'm gonna tell you, that has become revelation. And then thou shalt ask, and who gonna make their way prosperous though?
I am.
Huh? So Justin, it's up to you. It's up to you, my man. I'm waiting on God. You not just be waiting. Well, everybody's having experience, you're on the wait list. See, everybody's living, Lord, I'm waiting on Jesus. And you got everybody else out there being Jesus. Say, Bob.
Hello. All right.
You see, and I'm coming out and they said, I'm out.
I'm back. Hello.
And I want the world to know.
I got to let it show.
Come on, man. And I'm going to let it show.
Yes.
How many is hearing this? Are you hearing this here?
Yes, sir.
See, God ain't spoken, we spoken.
Say.
Ooh, man. Thank God having fun. My problem somewhere at a Kenny G concert.
Say,
kick back, relax, and say, look at all the beautiful world I made the people in.
Say,
suffering. Man, I'm gonna tell you something. When you dating your woman don't want to hear Sweet Hour of Prayer on the day.
Sweet Hour
of Prayer. That woman, she might want some Kenny G.
Say.
Bless your hearing. You may need your hearing blessed.
Kenny.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I'm about to marry this beautiful couple. Man, she ain't going here. Come on here. Amazing Grace.
Say.
I mean, it will be Amazing Grace, the favor of God, but she ain't gonna hear the whole religious song. Now, y'all like that other song. Amazing. The devil. Come on. She might want to hear that version in the way coming by Luther. You ain't heard that. See, y'all ain't ready for that. You ain't ready to make God. What? Man, Martin Luther saved a bunch of marriages back in the day. He told them to be in a house. What it was, a house, not a home?
Yeah.
Come on, he gave a marriage course through a song. You heard nothing I said. Y'all missing God. I was up in that man getting convicted.
See?
Come on, Luther, back up off me. Y'all all right? Stay with me. See, this word of God has to get down in your spirit. You got to get rich with this word.
Amen.
You got to become the word.
Yes.
Are y'all hearing this here?
Yes.
So you're going to meditate. Meditate is to ponder. It means to rehearse over and over and over and over and over. And you know what? The word don't discriminate. It'll come wherever you are. Whatever you're going through, it'll get you right there.
Right there.
But don't take it, it'll come in the valley.
Say.
Hey, come on. Come on. Who's that, David? They said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Come on now.
He maketh me to lie down in green pasture. Yea, though I walk through the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. See, that's valley language.
Say.
That's valley conversation. So you gotta encourage yourself in the fact.
Yes, sir.
Look at you, he called him shepherd. When it luck, you ain't got no shepherd. He running from Saul. You see what I'm saying? But he declared that the Lord is my shepherd.
Yes.
And he still prophesied because he said the shadow, he didn't call it death, he said the shadow.
Come on, baby.
See that thing, you think it's just a shadow. No, it's just a shadow. Don't be scared of the shadow. It ain't showing up, it's just a shadow.
Come on, baby.
It's just a phone call. It ain't just a roll, it ain't a line, it's just rolling. Because you got the line of Judah in you.
All right.
That's a pup hollering at you.
Say, come on now.
Are you hearing me, sister? Are you hearing me, Sister Kimmy?
Come on now.
Are y'all getting this? Are you getting this, Brother Sam?
Yes, sir. Master, this
is
true.
You got houses here. This good stuff. Right. See, the day of just coming in the presence of God and leaving the same is over. This is an empowerment session.
Yes, sir.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Yes.
Man, now, I tell you to go mess with some stuff when you leave here.
Yeah.
I'm telling you to mess with some stuff.
Now.
You gotta go and do that thing. You gotta go and do that thing.
Yes.
I said it's yours for the taking.
Yes,
are you in that? I said it's yours for the taking.
Yes.
Meditation. Say meditation.
Meditation.
Revelation.
Revelation.
Manifestation.
Meditation.
Now watch this here. Talk about that word. And see, when you meditate, that's that fellowship with God. You're fellowship with the word. You're enriching your spirit. All you're hearing, you ain't got time for negativity. You ain't got time for nothing negative. You ain't got time for nothing grace in your spirit. You ain't got time for that. You ain't got time for a loser's conversation.
Come on now.
Amen.
You ain't got time for nobody telling you what you can't do.
Hello.
You know people always talking about what you can't do, and they ain't did nothing.
He's
always the one that ain't never did nothing. Never did nothing. But they always talk what you can't do. Mm-hmm. Girl, if I wasn't you, I'm glad I ain't you. I'm glad you ain't me.
See.
Man, you know, that ain't gonna work. No, ain't gonna work for me. Mm-hmm. Now watch this here. Let's go to Psalms right quick. Are y'all with me?
Mm-hmm.
Go to Psalms right quick. Okay. Let's go to Psalms. Psalms, the first chapter. So Psalms, the first chapter. So right there. Psalms, first chapter, just hang right there. Now listen to this here. Psalms, first chapter. Y'all there?
Yes.
It says this here. Now this is what we're talking about, this word now. Psalms 1st chapter. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. You got to watch ungodly folks.
Come on.
Ungodly folks, man, they'll drain the life out of you.
Yes.
They'll steal your hope. You'll wake up thinking you can own the world by fire. You don't think you can own nothing. You don't even think you can own your name no more. Isn't it something how some people can come in the room and just drain you?
Come on now.
I know I was somewhere else. I said, who came in the room? I just felt depleted. Felt like somebody violated me. You know, I mean, they just walked in the room. Somebody said hello to this life out of you. What the? Who was that? And then there's something can walk in the room and bring charisma. I mean, you know they in the room, but it bring an expectation.
Come on.
Man. I said they bring an expectation. Because you, that's a whole nother sermon. I don't really want to get into that, but that's a whole nother sermon. But they bring an expectation. Mm-hmm. Some people bring a hope off in the room.
Yes.
They bring an expectation. When you say their name, you know that name means something.
Come on now.
You know that name. But when your name come up, they expect you to have it.
Come on now.
Okay, Psalms 1. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, or standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scoffer. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. His delight is in the law of the Lord. His delight is in the word of God.
Come on now.
Are we hearing this evening? And in the law do he there it is. And in the law do he meditate. Do he meditate day and night? Back and forth with you, I gotta meditate. I ain't got time to be asking your questions. I gotta meditate.
Come on now.
I ain't got time to be cussing you out. I gotta speak blessings.
Say,
I ain't got time to be hollering at you. I gotta keep my spirit in peace.
Hello.
I ain't got time to prove nothing to you.
Amen.
Say,
huh? Are you hearing what I'm saying? Are you hearing, Brother Kim? See, you ain't got time to be sweating. So-and-so said that you say, what? wait, excuse me, I'm sorry. You say what? Well, so-and-so said that you say. Look, you take your 7-Eleven mentality and get up out of here. Because I'm going to the nations, and I ain't got time to address you.
Come on, man. That's
good. Who cares about what somebody said about they said? They, if you think that's something, wait what they're going to say in a minute. Check back with me in the morning. You can really have something to say. I tell you what, call me. You know what? They said that you said, okay, tell you what you do. Let's hold the call right there. And I want you to call me back. This time tomorrow, I'm going to add to what we're seeing. Better still, give me your address. I'm going to show you what we're seeing.
Say.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? Since you the press, since you the star telegram. You want me to send you a picture? Because I'm going to say I'm about to send you a moment in time.
Come on.
Whoa!
Man.
You hear nothing I said? Girl, I heard you lost this. Yeah, but did you hear what I bought, though?
Yeah.
I heard you got fried, but did you hear that I own a Fortune 500 company, though?
Come on now.
And your boss about to work for me.
Hello. Say.
Now listen. I want you to hear this here. He said, meditation. He said, watch this here. Let's go here again. Psalms 1, verse 2. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in the law do he meditate. You know what you need to do? Is give your mind a good workout.
Yes, sir. Every day.
Look around you some water. Get you some soft music. Cut the lights down. And boy, you boy that mind will work around water.
Train yourself.
Some stuff coming. Woo! You ain't seen nothing yet. And if you can see it in your mind, you will see it in your reality.
Right.
Yeah, right.
Come on.
You only can see it because it exists. See, whatever your spirit is, you can create. Okay. We're going to call this. Now, I'm going to work here now. Y'all, not this. This is only strictly for demonstration. We're going to call this the light side. We're going to call this the dark side. We all are light, only for demonstration. No darkness in here for record sake. Big part. Say what now? What you said, baby? What you
said? I said darkness is part of light. It's on the other side.
Yeah, it's on the other side.
So it's not tripping.
Okay, so, incident, you made me lose my thought. Now you're responsible to bring it back. So I was getting ready to say, well, really interrupted. So, the dark side, in now what I call it, the light side?
No, we were light side.
Who was who?
We light.
Can we give this picture simple message? Okay, so who say dark, who say light? I can't because I don't know which side I'm on. This was the dark side. Are you dark? You the dark side, and you the light side. And so why was I even sharing this here? Okay, what does it have to do with the price of milk? We were talking about meditation, so.
Yeah, right.
So, can somebody help me? How did we get?
You were having the demonstration.
Yeah, you were.
Okay, but why was I having a demonstration?
Oh.
To create. Oh, to create.
Yes.
How to create. So I must have been trying to create from the dark side.
Yes, sir.
But if there's no light in the dark side, you can't create from the dark side unless there's light in the dark side.
Come on.
So a light will come out of skirt.
Did y'all hear that truth?
Hello.
Work your profit.
So, lights couldn't have been invented if they weren't already hidden in the dark.
Come on.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Hello.
The lights are on because they came out of nothing.
Yes.
They came out of something. They came out of nothing, but came out of something.
Yes.
So the thing that we're seeing, the word said Colossians, the thing that we're seeing was not made by the things that are seen. Mm. So that means there's another realm called the unseen. It's the realm where the enemy don't know what you're up to because he can't see it. It's a mystery unto him because he don't know. For it's given unto you to know the dark side.
Wait a minute.
It is given unto you to know the things that don't appear, that appear. In the light side, but in the dark side.
Thank you, Lord.
Are you here?
You gotta write that down.
See, until you're able to something to work with nothing, you'll never be able to work with something.
Come on now.
Did y'all get that? So don't be tripping.
So how do you get it going if you have nothing? You talk it up.
Oh.
Yeah. Genesis 1 said, let there be. You didn't sneak in, you were spoken in. You didn't sneak in the earth, you were spoken here.
Come on now.
You didn't just ease through the door, he spoke you in.
Hello.
God was here. He announced us.
See, we think it all started with the wallet. No, it don't. It started with a spoken word.
Come on now.
It wasn't a credit card. He didn't use a credit card to create the world. He had conversation. Conversation creates generations. And it caused things to generate. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying?
Come on now.
Okay, young
people. Are y'all hearing this here? Talk it up.
Amen.
Talk it up.
Jesus.
Your life is a reflection of what you talk about.
Amen.
So you believe in dancing in the park by yourself?
Say
what? He got a lot of video. He just dancing. You know, he just take his temple. He just go to the park. He pull up. I don't know what he be using. I don't know where he's gonna be every time I look on. I don't know where he like. I don't know. He like the outside of a wall. I don't know. All I just see is one of my members. I have come to the side. I see he's one of the members. He wall climbs, mountain climbs. He can dance anywhere with a song. So
one of your sons.
One of my sons in the spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
But if you believe it, it'll get in your spirit. And you'll act on what's in your subconscious. Even when nobody ain't looking.
Come on now. Say.
See, you can always tell when something you're dry because you can do without an audience.
Say.
You ain't written nothing, I say. You'll do it till audience show up.
Hello.
You may be the only one clapping for yourself when you get through. Lord have mercy.
Come on, man.
Then one day you'll find yourself at Carnegie Hall. Standing ovation.
Say.
Yeah, when I was a little boy, I used to go out of arm. See, I taught her well, so she remembers it. When I was a little boy, I would always wanted to be a journalist. I wanted to be a broadcaster when I was young. And so I would go out and we had a porch. And it was a little split like this, and you had grass over here, and you had grass over here. And in my imaginary mind, those were people. And I was speaking to those people. And I was bringing them hope. I didn't know no word, but what I was saying was life. I didn't know the scriptures, but what I said, it was life. And you know, we had about the greenest yard on the street. Because I talked to it.
Say.
And other grass would go back in and get other grass and come back out.
Say.
You hear nothing I say. Say.
See,
y'all think I'm playing. You think
say.
I'm playing.
Come out.
I come out the next day, like there'd be a flower there. See, stuff produced out this own kind. If somebody like what you like,
say,
you just got to get in front of them. For everyone that reject you, there's four more that will accept you.
Say.
Are y'all hearing this here? Mm-hmm. Let me finish reading this here for time. We got about 15 minutes. Let me finish reading this for time's sake. So he says, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in the law do he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Who should be like a tree? The person full of the word. That's planted. Watch this here. Listen, I want you to hear this here. I want you to hear this now. It's going to bless you. And he shall be like a tree planted. The one that what? Meditates day and night on the word. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit. His fruit. Are you hearing this here? In his season. When you get that word planted in your subconscious, it may not look like nothing's happening, but in the right season, that word's going to flourish. That word's going to be built up.
Yes.
That word's going to become fruitful. When the storm hit, that word's going to be fruitful because you didn't build up that word.
Say,
I want you to listen to this. Listen to this here.
Yes, sir.
And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. You get front of that word, you're going to be around nothing but life. You don't want to be around no desert. You don't want to be around no dry, dead people.
Say,
but you want to be around somebody full of life. Listen, and he should be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth fruit in his season. And his leaf, and his leaf also shall not wither. And what he produced and the fruit that he produced will not die. See. But it will love the life.
Come on now.
Huh? You following? Huh? You remember that little saying you come on TV? We don't die, we just multiply. Is that black baby? We don't die, we just multiply. You get full of that word, we don't die, we just multiply. Huh? Are you hearing what I'm saying? See, that word get it start multiplying.
Yes.
That word get in you, it start answering. That word get in you, it start creating stuff for you. His leaf shall not wither, and what's it here? And whatsoever he doeth, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. And whatsoever, and the dispensation of whatsoever is connected to the manifestation, and the dispensation of whatsoever.
Come on now.
You hear nothing I say. And the dispensation of whatsoever. You hear nothing I say. Are y'all ready? This is in the Bible. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I'm about to start telling the flip over to the front door to walk.
Come on,
man. Did you hear this?
Ooh, yeah, baby.
Did you hear this? Did you hear this?
So we make our way prosperous.
Did you hear what this said?
Oh, yeah.
Get on that page.
Come on,
baby. Did you hear what this said? Wait a minute. and he shall be like a tree. Who is he? The man that meditate day and night, the woman that meditate day and night, and he shall be like a tree planted. He's stable. People that meditate is stable. They got their thought locked in.
Come on,
you can't sway them. You see what I'm saying? I know I'm great. You can't, I don't have no self-esteem. You can't tell me it ain't my season. You can't tell me I can't have it. You can't tell me I gotta keep tabernacling with small. You can't tell.
Jesus.
I ain't scared. I ain't scared. Y'all ain't scared, are you?
No.
Are you in this here?
Come on, the mastery of life.
You're in this here. Man, this word works. Man, this word works, man.
Yes,
you're a great man of God. You're a great man of God. This word works, man. You've been working. Boy, this word works. I said, this word works. Blessed are those that can hear. See, I ain't worried about how you talk. See, if you hear right, you're going to talk right. Your first test is going to be an ear test. Your first test is the ear test. And then your second test is a perception test. How you see it after you hear it.
All right.
Because then your ears and eyes got to marry one another.
Oh.
And then when the ears and eyes marry one another, then your tongue going to say, I do.
Oh. All right, right.
Do you try to tell the truth? Nothing but truth, but help me God.
I do.
And when you say I do, your creation going to happen.
All right.
And then creation going to say, let it be.
All right.
And even in the morning was the second day. And even in the morning was the third day. Now your words are in motion.
Yes.
I said your words are in motion. Then when you start walking in the authority of God, then your words going to be like God. And God's voice begin to walk in the cool of the garden. And then your voice going to begin to walk creation before you get there. Before you turn the corner, your voice going to be already in the deep.
Yeah.
Your voice will come on up in the and talk to you.
Right. Thank you, right.
Man, your schedule's booked, son.
Thank you, Father.
I said, your schedule's booked.
Yes, sir, it is.
I said, your schedule's booked.
Yes, it is.
Can I prophesy something to you?
Oh, my goodness.
I see Tyler Perry summons you. To be a movie. I knew the prophet of God. I said, Tyler Perry, well, you were starring one of his movies. I didn't stutter. Put this camera on me. I told you this, and I won't have time. You better cool me in the beat.
Come on now.
Bishop Jace, his friend's the title here. Deep into it, let me leave you alone.
Come on.
We was at the Potter's house yesterday, and I hooked their temple, and I told them to that stage. I said, man, you want solo on there. How great that are. Is that the song?
Great.
What is it?
Be Great.
Be Great.
That was my words.
No, great.
Say.
Mm-hmm.
See.
Come on now.
You ready, sir?
Yes, sir.
All right.
You ain't got to be there to be there.
Say.
See, when that word become revelation, when you get it in your subconscious, creation knows it.
Yeah.
They already start preparing stuff.
They summoned you.
You follow what I'm saying? See, your words go before you. And the word of God is sent. And wherever the word of God is sent, it ain't coming back forward.
Say.
The word of God will go out and get whatever you got a revelation of.
All right.
Someone told me he was house looking yesterday. I said, no, she's not house looking. She's house possessing.
Thank
she's possessing you. Stuff.
Right.
She's messing with stuff.
Right.
Food me. Now, when the door pop, be sure to walk on in now. You on the food with a lock because you want it to open.
Amen.
You know it's locked, but you keep picking with it. You know what I'm saying? You keep picking with it. Man, I love it. You got to keep it. Keep picking with it. Some say it's time to pick with it. Said, oh, that's old folks. Stop picking. We hear this here?
Yes, sir.
So let me read this in the whole, and then we're done. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit and his season. And his leaves also shall not wither, but whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Because you meditate on the word of God. So you got a house that word. You got to meditate that word there. You ain't got time to think nothing else.
Amen.
You ain't got time to think nothing else but what God sees.
That's right.
You ain't got time to think nothing else but what God sees. Mm-hmm. Great is he that's within you than he that's in the world. Are we hearing this here?
Yes.
Are we hearing that? Word of God will give you wisdom. Somebody took Daniel, I think it's 2:21. That word of God will give you wisdom, and when he give you wisdom, it'll give you understanding.
Yes, it is.
Somebody, I think it's Daniel 2:21. Somebody turn it right quick. Somebody turn to Daniel. That word of God will make you look good. When it look like you know good, it'll prosper you. It'll prosper the works of your life. It's life. Someone said that word of God is life.
Mm-hmm.
You get that word in your subconscious and don't let it go. But you'll be prophesying. You're right. You won't be a slave to the system. The system be a slave to you. You'll be running everything. You'll be calling those things to be done. So did anybody get Daniel 2? Daniel 2? What does it say?
And he changed the times.
Read a little loud.
And he changed the times and the season. He removed the kings and set it up kings. He gave wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that know understanding.
What I tell y'all? What I tell you?
Daniel 2:21.
Right. And he changes the times and the season and removed the kings. Some say he changed the time. And see, when you get to meditate on that word, he's going to start working for you. Yeah. He'll move stuff out your way. He'll make it your season when it ain't your season. Mm. Are you following what I'm saying? Mm. See, he'll bring kings out to raise you up.
Yay! Yeah.
He'll fire them out to hire you in. Yeah.
Jesus.
He'll make them come down interested in somebody to put the spotlight on you.
Come on, man.
You just drive on the scene, all of a sudden you flavor to you. All of a sudden, nobody knows you. Not everybody knows.
Yes, sir.
You hear nothing I said. You go from a no name to a house name.
Come on now.
Because he did say, I'll make your name great.
Yes,
he
did.
He said, I'll make your name great.
Yes, he did.
So he says here, Daniel answered and said,
come on.
What is it? No. Daniel answered and said, bless be the name of the God forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his. For wisdom and might are his. 21. And he's changed the time and the season. He removed kings and set up kings. He giveth wisdom to the wise. He give wisdom to the wise. So if you follow the word, he going to give you wisdom. Then he going to give you understanding.
Yes.
He giveth wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that no understand.
All right.
Are y'all getting that?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to just stop. Y'all get that? I'm going to just stop.
Amen.
3 John 2 said, beloved, I wish above all things that you would prosper, even as your soul prospers. You got to get your soul prosperous. You got to get your spirit prosperous by meditating on the word day and night. Amen?
Amen.
Let's step to our feet right quick. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Someone say meditation.
Meditation.
Before revelation.
Before revelation.
Before manifestation. Meditation before manifestation. Amen. Amen. It's your season. I challenge you. If you can freeze that thought in mind, you'll have that experience. Receive it in mind. Whatever you imagine, whatever you meditate on, it'll come off in your spirit. As a man, what? As a man thinking. So is it. Don't matter what you think about it. What I think. What do you think about yourself?
Come on, man.
If you're in this place today, God is putting time back on your side.
Glory to God, I receive it.
All you got to do is activate the word of God.
Activate
the word of God. Corresponding actions. Corresponding actions. I say corresponding. I command you to live out of the mind of God. He said, let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus. David said, my tongue is a pen of a ready writer. Can you speak it in? Can you prophesy it in? Can you speak it in? Can you prophesy? Can you call those things that be not as though they were? In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I bind the spirit of distraction that was distract you, that would cause you not to be focused on the word of God. I bind everything that would hinder you, that would come against your thought life, that would keep you from being productive in the spirit. If you're in this place today, there's divine favor going to hit your life like never before. In the name of Jesus, you are a great man of God. God's hand is all upon you. All upon you. Man, all you needed was the word. I see you when I came in. I knew it was something about you. It's something about you. But I hear the word of God saying that he's the equalizer to your life today. He's going to make the playing field even again, and God is restoring. God is restoring in this season. It's your time, it is your season, said the Lord. And what you thought would happen, will happen. God is favoring you. You're not in here by accident. You ran into your God today. The God that you knew from a child. The God that you knew from a child. It is your time. It is your season. It is your time. And you know what? I see a new hope rising in you. I see a new hope rising in you. I see a new hope. I see the favor of God. I see new opportunities open unto you, said the word of the Lord. I see it. I see it. I know it. Restoration, restitution, said the word of the Lord. Hey, God said the curse is broken. Yesterday is over. Remember, you're not the former thing. Neither consider the things of old. Behold, I do a new thing. This is a game changer. You've been empowered today.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know, I don't know what you do, but I see you working. I see somebody getting ready to hire you in. But I just see. I mean, your whole life is going to change. The next 30 days of your life is going to be, it's going to blow your way. It won't even be about where you came from. They're going to take a liking to your spirit, and they're going to hire you in, and you're going to have your own. I see a place with a zip code. I see an address. If I be a prophet of God, I'll proceed it. And the word was made flesh.
Hallelujah.
And I command you to live again, said the Lord. I command, for I made thee the head and not the tail. Above only and not beneath. Bless company and bless company. Everything you touch shall prosper. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God said, you are Joshua. You are conqueror. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And you shall write a book that shall say from this to that.
Hallelujah.
You shall dream again. And you shall prosper. Victory. Someone point to the man of God and say victory.
Victory.
Hallelujah. I'm going to show you how God favored you. For you, I want you to stay there to the end. But I want everybody to put something in this man's ear. This is good ground. I said, this is good ground. Put something of faith in this man even before he leaves. Find something of faith to put in his ear. Don't you leave. Don't you leave. Don't you leave. Don't you leave.
Jesus.
Don't you leave. I want everybody to put something in this man's hand before you leave. Oh, shit, it's over. Glory to you. Glory be to God. Shine out of the book, run to the ocean. Condor the devotion and the book, run to the ocean. Condor the devotion. Oh, I feel a little more of God. Come on, give God some praise. Let's go. If you don't know the Lord and the partner of your Savior, you can know him today as the word of God. You can know him today as the word of the Lord. You can know him today as the word of the Lord. You can know him today as the word of the Lord. You can know him today as the word of the Lord. Miracles, miracles, miracles. And the greatest miracle that you can receive. The greatest miracle that you can receive. I said the greatest miracle.
receive. The greatest miracle that you can receive is to receive the Lord as your personal Savior. All you have to do is ask God to forgive you of your sins. Just ask Him to forgive you of your sins. And ask God to come into your life. Because if you believe that God sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to die for you and raise Him from the dead, that you could be saved.
Thank you.
You can have it as your personal Savior today. It's just that simple. And repeat this prayer with me. You out there in social media land. Say, Lord, forgive me of my sins.
Thank you.
And God, I believe that you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to die for me and raise Him from the dead that I can be saved. And I receive Him as my personal Savior now. Now say, Holy Ghost, fill me with your Spirit. If you repeated that prayer, you're saved. And God will do the rest. Pray that you stay around the word. If you don't have a church home, keep listening to this broadcast. But God will lead you wherever you are. Come on, give God some praise. Come on, give God some praise. Now listen, it's going to bless you. The same day Jesus went out of the house and sat beside the sea. Some Bibles say beach. Great crowds assembled around him. So that, get my iPad out of there. Get my iPad for me. Because I think I want to read this in the Message Bible. It is so profound. But I'm going to start here and I may go back and read the Jesus Message Bible because it really breaks it down. But you got to hear this. This is going to bless your life. Someone say, I got what it takes.
I got what it takes.
Let's say that. Ignore this episode. Y'all bear with me. Just hold it right there. Just hold it right there. Okay. 1 second here. Someone say, thank God for technology.
Thank God for technology. There we go.
I'm going to start reading it from here. Then I'm going to go back and read it here. Now watch this here. Okay. Matthew 13 chapter. It says, that same day Jesus went out of the house and sat beside the sea. Great crowds assembled around him, so he went into a boat and sat there, and the whole assembly stood on the shore. Then he told them many things in parables, saying, listen. First thing he said, listen. It's going to require your attention. To listen, that means that you're going to have to stop everything that you're doing. Other than listening. Anything that don't protect, all distractions must stop when God says listen.
Amen.
There's times in your life where God says, now listen. The first thing he's going to say is listen. I need you. This is a season where you must listen. You can't listen with an attitude. You can't listen with a bad spirit because you're going to be distracted. Because you're going to be listening to respond. You're going to listen through offense. Are y'all hearing this? All right, Michaela, help me out. Okay, so he says, listen. Someone say, listen.
Listen.
Someone say, in this season,
in this season,
I must listen. Listen, a sower went out to sow. Now, the sower is God. A sower went out to sow. While he sowed, some neat seeds fell beside the path. And the birds came and devoured them. But other seeds fell on rocky ground where they did not have much soil. And immediately they sprang up because they did not have deep soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched. And because they did not take root, they withered away. Some seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. But other seeds fell into good ground and produce grain 100, 60, or 30 times as much. Whoever has ears to hear, let him hear. Now I'm gonna read this in the Message Bible. Stay with me, we're going somewhere with this here. It says, at about that same time, Jesus left the house and sat on the beach. And no time at all, crowds gathered around the shoreline. Who don't like to be on the beach? Hearing truth. He's that kind of God.
Come on now.
Let's come to the beach. Let me teach you in the beach. Mm-hmm. Come by the water side. Yeah. What good is it to meditate the word but by water? Uh-huh. Go somewhere with this. So about that same time, Jesus left the house and sat on the beach. And in no time at all, the crowds gathered around the shorelines, forcing him to get into the boat, using the boat as a pulpit. See, God is always creative.
Yes.
He addressed the congregation, telling stories. What do you make of this? A farmer planted seed. As he scattered the seed, some fell on the road and buried it. Some fell in gravel and sprouted quickly, but didn't put down roots. So when the sun came up, it withered so as quickly. Some fell in weeds and came up, and it was strangled by the weeds. Some fell on good earth and produce a harvest beyond the wildest dreams. Are you listening to this? Are you really listening?
Hello.
When the word of God is sown, now the different breakdown of this here, the word fell on different hearts. That's why it didn't produce the same. Some 30, some 60, some 100. It depends on what heart it's on. But when the word of God is sown, the word of God must go down in your spirit. Are you following what I'm saying? And you must house that word in your subconscious. It's not enough just to read the word and remember it, because you will forget it. I'm going to show you something in a minute. The word was designed for you first before you quote it, is to meditate. You hear nothing I said. You must meditate the word of God first. That's not a call. God bless you, Brother Ryan. You must meditate the word of God first. Someone said meditate.
Meditate.
You must meditate the word of God first before you speak it. Because when you meditate it first, to meditate is to meditate. To meditate is to go over and over and over and over and over and over and over. And the more that you meditate that word, the more you pounded it in your subconscious. You can't just be conscious, because you're going to be conscious of that you're subconscious of. If it's not in your subconscious, your conscious ain't going to be able to hold it. That's why you have double-minded people. Because you're trying to remember something with your head that your subconscious don't have revelation of. But when you get in your spirit, you can do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know what I'm talking about? See? See, that's why you can pick up a new routine quick, because when you get it in your spirit,
yeah,
it's automatic. Then at the choir, you know, you're not going to be counting on the day of the big stage. You're not at the choir because it's going to be in your spirit.
Hello.
Come on here. I'm quoting the word, but I'm quoting the word. Because I've become the word. That I was saying I am. Mm-hmm.
Hello.
The other day you show up as the word.
Say right.
Before you say something, it'll say something to you. Come on, Jesus, have you come to torment us before your time? He hadn't said nothing. Because he was full of the word. He just came walking in some wild asses, wild peas, and demons, and different things. Began, have you come to torment us before our time? He ain't said nothing. He just walked in the streets, man and baby.
Hallelujah.
But the word that was spoken had took on form. Come on, John 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. And the Word became flesh.
Hallelujah.
And the Word became, that that's written became flesh. In the Scripture became revelation. In the Scripture became revelant. In the Scripture became flesh. It took on flesh. Mm-hmm. So when you walk on the scene, they know, who are you?
Hello.
There's a difference in the way you look. We stress, but you ain't. You in the same waters that we are, but you ain't. You know how the disciples was at the top? Come on. You know when they was going across on the other side, they said, let us go on the other side? And when they see, now watch this, the word of God was in their boat. Let's call the word of God was in their life. But the word of God was at the bottom of the boat. Let's call that subconscious.
Come on.
Let's call the bottom of the boat subconscious. While they was at the top being conscious and fearful, not contacting the self-conscious at the bottom, which is Christ.
Hello.
Are you hearing what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because the self-conscious was at peace. It was sleep. But the mind was troubled and worried.
Same.
And so when the mind did go to the self-conscious, the mind said, the natural mind said, Lord, we perish, we perish. And the subconscious didn't understand what they were talking about. Because the subconscious never loosed that language in the earth. Wow. He said, let us go over.
Same.
Along with your conscience, there's a subconscious. But we both must marry one another to make the journey. You're trying to do something with your mind without your subconscious. I got to speak before that, y'all know something. What is the word he's talking about? Meditation before manifestation. That's what I'm talking about. That's the word. Meditation before manifestation.
Yes.
You're trying to manifest something that you ain't meditating.
Hello.
See, you will carry out that thing that you meditate. That's why they said the courtroom it was meditating.
Hello.
Meditated murder. It was premeditated. They had it that you intentionally did it. You know that you thought about this when you took on the action. So we charged in your car. So therefore, what are you saying, brother? I'm trying to tell you, when you premeditate And you call it, you was trying to call it into existence against the odds, against the thing that was troubling you, against defeat. Someone say premeditated victory.
Premeditated victory.
I'm charging you today with, God's charging you with premeditated victory in the first degree. Giving you life, a premeditated victory. Spiritually, physically, mentally, financially, socially, economically. Charge you to come to another level in your faith.
Yes, sir.
Charge you to come to another level in your faith. You don't have a choice in the kingdom.
Mm.
It ain't number one choice in the kingdom. My way is the highway to the way. And that way is Christ.
Amen.
Oh, I got lost today. I got more word than I got time. But I'm going to get you this word. Are y'all hearing this here? Are you hearing this here?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Now, watch this here. Now let's go. So the sower is sowing the word, but notice this word is not taking root to everybody.
Come on now.
Because when the curls of life show up, different things happen. Listen here. Let's do Matthew 13, verse 10. The disciples came and said to him, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" He answered them, "It is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them that is not given, it is not given." Now, what's a mystery? A mystery is anything that you don't know about God is a mystery to you. If you don't know that you can walk in victory, that's a mystery. If you don't know you can be healed, that's a mystery. If you don't know you're the head and not the tail, above all and not beneath, blessed come in, blessed come out, everything you touch prosper, that's a mystery. And God didn't create the world for it to be a mystery to you.
Amen.
He said, "It is given unto you." This is the language of the kingdom. Are you hearing me? This is the language of the kingdom. Hello, Facebook world.
Hello.
Social media. This is the language. There's a language to getting God to move for you.
Come on now.
Are y'all hearing this here?
Mm-hmm.
Now listen. He answered him, "It is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God." But I tell you, the kingdom of God functions off a word.
Mm-hmm.
It functions off of the word. The kingdom of God functions off the mind of God. The kingdom functions off of the king's word. If there's a kingdom, there's a king. And the kingdom operates off of kingdom principles. Principles are laws. Are you following what I'm saying? Laws are different from values. Values are priorities, but laws are different. You can have, this is my values, family, all this, but we're talking about principles now. Laws.
Mm-hmm.
What laws govern you coming out? What law are you using? What right are you using? What law are you using to come about? I know you don't like it, but it ain't gonna change because you don't like it. What law do you have to say you got put up with it?
Right.
What contract do you have?
Come on now.
Are you following what I'm saying? See, where you live at, you shouldn't have to pull out your contract to show it to tell somebody to get off your property. Because you didn't have the contract so long, you meditate on it, get off my property. I'm not showing you the details. I said you better be gone when I get back. Because now I'm one with the contract. My insurance policy, I ain't got to flash my car. When I go to the Mercedes house to get my oil, I got to let the Tabernacle Beverly house drive it off. We don't need nothing, let's go. They know my rights and I know my rights.
Mm-hmm.
See, the atmosphere begin to know your rights.
Mm-hmm.
I just drive up and pass the keys. Mr. Johnson, take the one in front. Take the Mercedes in front. Have a nice day.
Mm-hmm.
They ain't check nothing because I have rights. I've established a relationship.
Yeah, that's good.
They don't waste my time. Because I got rights. They know what they owe me. I know what they owe me.